After facing many trials and tribulations in the city of Hong Kong, Rao Singha, with the help of Cat Hellshire, Fenghua Jian, Grace Yi, and Ligan Wu, reclaimed his everlasting Shenzhou from the clutches of greedy millionaire Milton Cheng. However, Rao discovers a strange lock on top of the gourd, which prevents Rao from opening the divine wine. Through interrogation, Milton reveals to Rao that Maltia Kamiyama, a stage actress from Japan, has placed the lock on the everlasting Shenzhou and is the only person who can unlock it. Milton also reveals that Maltia is responsible for creating the Kaminohakai talisman that neutralizes the protection of the everlasting Shenzhou and now holds Cat Hellshire's everlasting Shenzhou, thanks to the masked mercenary Kurokage. Rao, Cat, and Fenghua now set sail on the cruise ship, the SS Berkeley, heading to Japan to find Maltia, unaware that the stage actress is waiting in the wings to make her grand entrance. It is now January 30th, 2020, 9 a.m., Yokosuka, Japan. The rising sun shines over the SS Berkeley, concluding its voyage as it approaches Yokosuka port. When the ship stopped, the passengers begin disembarking as Rao, Cat, and Fenghua stand on the highest deck, looking over the city of Yokosuka.
Ah, here we are at last. Japan.
It's been a while since I visited Japan. Great to be back.
Japan looks so vibrant. Ah, look, Rao-senshin. There's a huge mountain over there.
Fenghua points towards a distant mountain that is very familiar to the citizens of Japan.
That is Mount Fuji, Fenghua.
Mount Fuji. Even from here, Mount Fuji looks impressive.
It never ceases to amaze me whenever I see it. Hey, Rao, they say gods live there. Is that true?
More than you can imagine. Now show me the direction of the hotel you reserved, Cat.
That way. It's in Tokyo. Tokyo Tower Hotel is my favorite spot to crash whenever I visited the city.
All right. Well, I don't want to deal with the traffic, so...
Rao takes out and opens his sun fan.
So, that fan, it works just like the moon fan, but during the daytime, right?
That's right.
With one big swipe, Rao conjures a bright yellow cloud.
Hop on, ladies.
It's just as comfy as the night cloud. And so warm.
Ah, this feels so comforting. Good to ride on a cold day. Just make sure you keep the cloud low, okay, Rao?
No promises, Cat. Now let's go.
The cloud turns the trio invisible as they fly out of the ship. The trio fly through the wonderful city buildings of Yokosuka, quickly transitioning into the metropolis of Tokyo. At around 10 a.m., the trio have settled in their room at Tokyo Tower Hotel. The trio relaxes at the balcony with a great view of Tokyo Tower as Kat browses through the internet on her laptop.
Let's see. Maltia Kamiyama, a British-Japanese stage actress who has gained acclaim for her dynamic performances playing male and female roles.
She plays male roles?
Yeah, she was a member of a prestigious all-female theater group called Takarazuka, where its members either play an otokoyaku, which is a male role, or a musumeyaku, which is a female role. Maltia was mostly an otokoyaku based on her height, but her performances have gained many fans. She then left the group for unknown reasons.
Oh, I wonder why. She looks too pretty to play a male role. But looking at these pics of her as a male character, she pulls it off well. She looks very... charming.
So not long after she left the company, she became an entrepreneur and established a winery business in Tokyo called Kamiyama Winery. And then, around 2 years ago, she created her own theater company, Gekidan Kamiyama.
Gekidan Kamiyama.
Gekidan? What's a Gekidan?
It's Japanese for theater company. And from the looks of it, her Gekidan has grown quite quickly since it started. 100 members each in 4 ensembles. Genbu, Byakko, Suzaku, and Seiryu. Each one focusing on a performing art.
Genbu is the snake tortoise. Byakko is the tiger. Suzaku is the phoenix. And Seiryu is the dragon. What does each group do?
Let's see. Genbu Ensemble focuses on acting. Byakko Ensemble focuses on stage combat. Suzaku Ensemble focuses on music. And Seiryu Ensemble focuses on dance. Their shows received rave reviews throughout the country, presenting original stories, mixing in martial arts. They have theaters throughout Japan, but their main headquarters seems to be at Kamiyama Castle in Yamanashi.
A castle? This is a very fascinating group. I wonder if they hold auditions for the Seiryu Ensemble.
These 4 ensembles are named after the heavenly beasts, just like the ones on the lock, but what about that 5th one on the top?
That's the Kirin. Perhaps the most powerful of all the beasts.
Maltia has it on her hat as well. Looks like she's very fond of the heavenly beasts.
And apparently, the everlasting Shenjiu. Anything else on Maltia?
Actually, that's it. She keeps most of her info pretty private. Even her age is unknown.
So why would she want the everlasting Shenjiu?
I was thinking that the goal was to make money just like Milton. She has a business relationship with him, and there seems to be a deal between them where Maltia gets a piece of the profits. But I think there's more to it.
Why else?
Milton mentioned something about a project Maltia is doing.
A project?
Maybe a theater project for Gekidan Kamiyama?
Maybe. We need to find Maltia to find out and have her unlock the everlasting Shenjiu. The village needs it with this virus still out there. I'll get it.
Rao opens the door to see a Japanese man silently give an envelope to him before quickly walking away.
Who's that, Rao?
I don't know. Someone gave me this large envelope. It's addressed to Gekidan Rao.
Gekidan Rao?
Strange. Oh, and look. Stickers of little anime chibi heads of us sealing the envelope. That's a little weird, but also kinda cute.
Rao opens the envelope. As the contents are revealed to be a letter, Rao begins to read it.
Gekidan Rao.
Yōkoso! Gekidan Kamiyama knows you're here in Japan, and we know you're here looking for Maltia-sama. We know where you are, and you are being watched. Come to Kamiyama Winery at 1 a.m. Bring the everlasting Shenjiu with you. That is your ticket inside the winery. Hina Chiba, manager of Kamiyama Winery, stage manager of Gekidan Kamiyama.
Well, looks like they know we're here. Gekidan Kamiyama doesn't seem like an ordinary theater company. Oh wait, there's more in the letter.
P.S. Fenghua Jian! I loved your performance in the Hong Kong dance concert! Please join Gekidan Kamiyama!
Looks like you got yourself a fan, Fenghua.
I guess so.
But how did they know where we are?
Rao walks towards the balcony to look outside, only to see a flying drone in the air before it quickly flies off into the sky. Kat and Fenghua join him as they also notice the drone.
Looks like that's our answer. Get ready to stay out late, ladies.
January 31st, 2020. As 1 a.m. arrived, the night was still young in Tokyo when Rao, Kat, and Fenghua walk through its bustling citizens as they arrive at the small but beautiful shop that is Kamiyama Winery. The trio found the entrance door locked.
There's nobody here.
Hey, there's a sticker near the door handle that looks like the wine lock, Rao Xinsheng.
Rao could see the illustration of the wine lock near the door handle.
Bring the everlasting Shenjiu with you. That is your ticket inside the winery.
Rao took out his locked, everlasting Shenzhou and used its wine lock to tap the illustration on the door, which is now immediately unlocked. The store was pitch dark when they opened the door. After the door was closed, lights went up to reveal a young, cute Japanese woman with large eyeglasses, wearing a bright pink kimono.
Gekidan no! Irashamase!
Welcome! My name is Hina Chiba. I'm the stage manager for Gekidan Kamiyama and manager of Kamiyama Winery.
Fenghua Jian! Oh, you look so beautiful in person! I watched your marvelous performance in the Hong Kong dance concert online! A very mesmerizing performance! Look, we have your poster promoting Shenqing Miracle!
The shock of seeing Hina went away as the trio took the moment to see the poster as well as the entire shop. The beautiful interior brought an elegant, warm feeling, with beautiful displays of wine from different brands, as well as various production still shots of Maltia Kamiyama in various productions that she has performed in, each bringing different expressions on her face. The trio approached the poster of Fenghua.
Hey, that's me.
Yes, it is. Please let me take a selfie with you in front of it.
Okay, I guess.
Hina took out her phone as both she and Fenghua posed for the camera, while Fenghua reluctantly smiled.
Sugoi! Arigatou gozaimasu!
Doitashimashite?
You know Japanese?
No. Kat taught me a few phrases. Did I say that right, Kat?
You said it very well, Fenghua.
I want to see Maltia Kamiyama. Where is she?
Upon hearing Rao, Hina regained her professional composure.
Now, son, if you wish to see Maltia-sama, then you must first participate in her project.
What's her project?
The Gekijo Kumite.
The what?
The Gekijo Kumite. Gekijo meaning theater. Kumite is sparring. Maltia-sama is conducting a series of no-holds-barred fights held in Gekidan Kamiyama's theaters, with various performing artists who are highly skilled in martial arts.
The Gekijo Kumite. I'm intrigued.
It's in its early stages, but Maltia-sama has much bigger plans for the Gekijo Kumite. Tonight, Maltia-sama wants you to fight one of Gekidan Kamiyama's ensemble leaders, Genichi Kamekura, leader of the Genbu Ensemble.
Doesn't matter who it is. I'll fight anyone if it takes Maltia to show herself. Name the place.
You will fight at the Genbu Theater.
Hina approaches what seems to be a closet door, which serves as the entrance of a maze-like pathway.
There is a secret pathway in the winery that will lead us to the Genbu Theater. Please, follow me.
The trio followed Hina in a walk that seems to last for half an hour.
So this Gekijo Kumite, how do you win it?
You win by knockout, submission, or knocking off the stage. There are three 30-minute rounds, which we will call acts, and there will be a 5-minute intermission after 30 minutes have elapsed. If there are no winners after three acts, the winner of the fight will be decided on points by me. But Maltia-sama can change the rules at any time.
Interesting.
So, how did you like my chibi drawing?
You drew that?
In my spare time, I love to draw. I love drawing many members of the Gekidan Kamiyama. But you three have very interesting looks that I just had to do chibi art on you.
It's very cute.
You think? I'm very happy you think so, Fenghua-sama.
Fenghua-sama?
Hina, how much farther until we get to the theater?
Just a few more minutes. We're almost there.
The group finally arrived to the secret entrance of Genbu Theater, guarded by two black-suited men who led them inside the dark but cozy 100-seat theater surrounding a circular stage.
This is Genbu Theater. We hold our dramatic plays here, which includes some modern and Shakespearean plays. We also do originals written by our best playwriters within the Genbu Ensemble.
Oh, wow, a theater in the round. This feels so intimate. And not a bad seat in the house.
Yes, we can configure it to proscenium staging. But not tonight. Please sit wherever you like. We will begin the show at 4 a.m.
At 4 a.m.? But it's about 2 a.m. right now. What are we going to do until then?
Memorize this script. It's written by Genichi.
Hina gives Rao the script.
Well, you never told us about memorizing a script.
It's short, but it's part of your challenge. You will be penalized if you mess up your line, so get it right. At 3:30, all three of you will wait in the backstage area as we will open house to our audience.
Now, are we fighting or are we acting in a play?
Both. Kind of. Prepare yourself, Dao-san. Excuse me.
Hina and the guards exit, leaving the trio alone in the theater.
Well, at least the script is short. Now let's see. Okay, we have this woman here making the introductions in Japanese. Okay, enter the stage, Rao Singha. Alright, that must be my cue. Genbu, which I'm assuming is Genichi, says his lines. And it looks like my only line is, Ha! Genbu the Actor. Do you believe you can defeat me? Then prepare to die. And then we fight. Well, speaking of scripts, how's that play coming along, Kat? You know, that play that you're writing.
Yes! Are you getting new ideas?
Oh, coming along well. It's still a work in progress.
Are you ever gonna tell us what it's about?
I will, when I'm ready.
Can't wait to hear it.
At 3:30 a.m., the trio sat backstage as the audience began entering inside the theater, as they all arrived very rowdy, but excited.
Wow. Well, that crowd looks like they came from a party.
They all look drunk, too.
Yeah, probably were clubbing in Roppongi. They have a huge nightclub scene there.
The music stops and the lights dim, as it is now 4 a.m.
Genbu Ensemble!
とっても特別な劇場組手チャレンジです。彼の才能あるダンサーの2人を伴って、そのうちの1人は最近香港旧正月ダンスコンサートで壮大なパフォーマンスを披露した後、ソーシャルメディアで世界的にトレンドになっている素敵なダンサー、ジアン・ファン・フワ。常に挑戦を探していて、中国で最高の戦闘機を打ち負かした武道に熟練した魔術師。 Enter the stage, Rao Singha!
Well, that's my cue.
Rao, Kat, and Fenghua make their way to the stage as Rao steps into it and looks around the crowd.
So, Enter the stage, Genbu the Actor! Kamekura!
A Japanese man emerges in the middle of the circular stage in an elaborate flamboyant robe with a black gourd with a gold snake tortoise plug on tied around his waist and wearing a snake tortoise mask.
Maltia-sama to Gekidan Kamiyama no nani kakete kono chousensha o taoshi Gekijo Kumite de mata hitotsu shouri suru. Rao Singha, welcome to the Genbu Theater. I'm Genichi, leader of the Genbu Ensemble. Tonight, Genbu the Actor takes the stage! Rao Singha, this is your last chance, you villain. Hand over the everlasting Shenjiu or suffer defeat from my hands!
Huh, Genbu the Actor, you believe you can defeat me? Then prepare to die.
Hey, Rao, look out!
Rao senses a rock and quickly dodges it. Genichi, however, catches the rock and crushes it with his bare hand. Rao is quite surprised at this occurrence.
What the hell was that, Genichi?
Stage actors must be prepared for curveballs. You better watch out.
Was that part of the script?
No, it was not.
How dare they trick Rao Senshin! Rao Senshin, there's another rock!
Rao catches the rock and with pinpoint accuracy, throws it back directly at the face of the person who threw it, breaking his nose and knocking him down, causing the rest of the audience to hesitate to throw more rocks at him.
So apparently there's audience participation in this challenge.
They are my ensemble members. All of them are on my side.
Yeah, of course.
All players step back, and stand on your nearest mark.
Rao and Genichi step back and did as they are told as the lights go dark.
Act one! Lights up! Fight!
Genbu the actor dashes towards Rao and grabs him. Rao suddenly has trouble escaping Genbu the actor's clutches.
You won't escape my clutches, Rao!
Come on, Rao! Teleport out of there!
You can't catch me, Rao. We saw your fight with Kurokage in Hong Kong. You couldn't teleport then either. Not without your drink. Everyone, throw!
The rocks raining down upon the two, but Rao is dealing with most of the damage. Fenghua stands up and begins to quickly fly around the theater, delivering a huge gust of wind throughout the theater, blowing everyone away from their seats, much to Genichi's shock.
My actors!
The gust left many knocked out.
There. Now no one else will throw rocks at Rao Singha.
Rao then delivers a huge kick to Genichi's groin.
Watch out for curveballs, remember?
As Genichi cowers down, he takes out his black gourd and drinks out of it, which revitalized him.
Now I feel better.
That gourd. You're drinking Shenjiu.
Hey, Gen bitch, take this!
Cat throws a rock towards Genichi. But Genichi smashes it with his fingertips. Genichi performs a snake fist stance.
Maltia-sama blessed me with godlike finger strength. No one can match the strength of my fingertips.
Genichi drinks more Shenjiu until the very last drop.
Stop drinking! You can't handle too much Shenjiu.
Ah, scared, Rao? You should be. Now, feel the power of my snake feet.
Genichi loses his balance, but gains his footing as he strikes his snake fist pose.
You're inexperienced in handling Shenjiu.
Silence, Rao! Feel the power of my snake fist!
As Genichi is about to dash towards Rao, Rao then performs his own snake fist posture, solid and steady. Rao and Genichi both engage in a snake fist battle. Rao easily evades Genichi's strikes and strikes him with his snake fist. As he does so, Genichi reacts strangely to the strikes.
What's with Genichi's reactions?
It seems like he's overselling Rao's attacks. Overacting it, really.
Flipping and flopping around, Genichi is overwhelmed by Rao's snake fist strikes. Genichi throws another attempted strike, but Rao evades and slices Genichi's wrists.
My wrists!
Even snakes need their blood.
Genichi tries to strike, but to no avail as the blood keeps pouring out of his wrist.
Snake enters stage right! Snake enters stage left! Snake enters center stage!
Rao delivers a flurry of snake fist strikes Genichi's chest and face, and then strikes at Genichi's temple on the hand, which stuns him. And then, the snake tortoise mask slowly crumbles and breaks to reveal Genichi's real face. But Genichi refuses to fall as he stares up at the spotlight.
Rao Singha, you may have defeated me, but the rest of the leaders won't let you pass. Long live Gekidan Kamiyama! Long live Maltia-sama!
Shut up and fall down already!
Cat throws a rock and hits Genichi in the face, who finally falls off stage. At the moment he makes contact to the floor, Genichi explodes as smoke engulfs the theater.
Shosha Lao Shiha!
Whoa! Within one act, the winner by knockout, Rao Singha!
And scene.
All right, Rao Sensheng. You won!
Well, that was overdramatic. Was that explosion really necessary?
And then, a blackout. The lights slowly dim back up to reveal the tall, statuesque figure of Maltia Kamiyama appearing before Rao on stage.
Well done, Rao Singha. You've defeated Genbu the Actor.
Maltia Kamiyama.
It's Maltia-sama to you.
Whatever you want to call yourself, unlock my everlasting Shenjiu and hand over Cat's gourd. You have no right to have that in your possession.
I give the directions here, Rao. If you want me to unlock your gourd, defeat the rest of the ensemble leaders. Genbu the Actor is only the warm-up round. Now go to Byakko Theater in Kyoto. Byakko the Fencer will be a much bigger challenge for you. Entertain me as you try to survive my Gekijo Kumite.
Smoke emerges from the ground as Maltia begins to disappear. Then, another blackout, as it blankets the Genbu Theater once again before the lights go up. The smoke clears as the trio could see that Maltia and Genichi have disappeared.
So that was Maltia Kamiyama. She does have that presence, and apparently knows how to make an exit.
Uh-huh. Rousichin, look at the wine lock.
Fenghua points to the wine lock as the eyes of the snake tortoise figurine begin to light up.
What's this supposed to mean?
That means you have defeated Genbu the Actor. Once you defeat a leader associated with the heavenly beast, the eyes of the beast on the lock will light up. Once they all light up, your gourd will be unlocked.
I see.
Gekidan dao! Omedetou gozaimasu! Congrats on your victory! Your call time for tomorrow, February 1st, is 7 p.m. I will meet you at Byakko Theater in Kyoto for your next challenge. Don't be late! Please go through the exit doors out of the theater. Have a nice day!
It looks like we have no other choice but to play Maltia's game if we want her to open the everlasting Shenjiu. We'll have to go with the flow and face whatever challenges come at our way.
Flow like the Lijian.
That's right. Now let's move on.
Yes, let's definitely move on. To bed. I need a nap.
The trio walk out of the Genbu Theater and towards a brand new day as the morning sun rises and shines upon Gekidan Rao. What challenge does Byakko the Fencer have for the trio when they arrive at Byakko Theater in Kyoto? Maltia Kamiyama's Gekijo Kumite continues next time on Everlasting Shenjiu.